9 out of this world facts about astronauts. Welcome to FIG. If we have a video about space, we surely should also have a video about astronauts. There are two ways to live your life. The first one is the one that we live here on Earth, and the second one is out in space, and is particularly designed for astronauts to live in. There is no gravity in space, and you do not have access to water or regular food like we do here on Earth. When we think of living in space, it seems easy from where we are, but in reality, it is extremely different from life on Earth. In fact, a NASA's astronaut's daily schedule is very unusual and hard to understand for people on Earth. In today's video, we will talk about some of this out-of-the-world facts about astronauts that you probably didn't know about. So, check it out and learn something new today. Sit tight and don't miss any portion of the video. Also, if you are new to the channel, remember to subscribe to the channel and hit the bell icon so you won't miss any future videos we upload. Let's get right into the video. Number 1. Astronauts wear diapers. NASA has made efforts to meet the physiological requirements of its astronauts. Maximum absorbency garments, aka MAG, and also known as space diapers, have already been developed. When going to the restroom isn't an option, astronauts wear this garment for takeoff, landing, spacewalks, and other extravehicular activities. Since astronauts must remain in their spacesuits for the duration of a flight, the MAG must be worn at all times in case of an emission. Like adult diapers, MAGs serve a similar purpose but have been redesigned so that they may be worn like shorts. They're meant to be worn below the LCV suit's liquid cooling and ventilation garment. In preparation for space shuttle flights, each astronaut is issued 3 MAGs, one for liftoff, one for landing, and a spare. Number 2. Astronauts age slower than Earthlings. This one could be a little hard to wrap your head around at first, but if you're familiar with the phrase relative time, owing to Einstein and his theory of relativity, it explains why this occurs. Time isn't flat, it's affected by matter and energy, so the passage of time might appear to speed up or slow down relative to our personal experiences, depending on where we are and how quickly we're moving. So, if we send astronauts to the ISS, they will age slightly more slower than us mere mortals down on Earth. Scientists have seen that time slows down near massive objects like the Earth. This is because massive objects bend space-time because of their gravity. Those on the International Space Station mature more slowly than those of us who live on Earth because of the effect of gravity. Although the time gaps aren't particularly large, even the largest of them would be measured in microseconds. Number 3. Understanding Russian is a must for astronauts. All astronauts working on the ISS must be fluent in Russian in order to do their jobs effectively. American astronauts operate one half of the ISS, known as the United States Operating Segment, or USOS. Russian cosmonauts handle the other half, known as the Russian Segment, RS. To properly communicate with one another, control both parts, and talk to specialists on Earth, astronauts and cosmonauts need to be fluent in both English and Russian. The Russian Soyuz rocket is used to transport astronauts to and from the International Space Station. So, astronauts had to learn enough Russian to not only run the equipment they needed, but also talk to experts on Earth who could fix any problems that came up. Number 4. Exercise is too important for astronauts. Here on Earth, we must continually fight against the pull of gravity, which puts a strain on our muscles and skeleton. However, because our bones and muscles don't have to do any work in space due to the extreme lack of gravity, they might become dangerously weak. Therefore, astronauts need to spend at least 2 hours every day using workout equipment to counteract the negative effects of zero gravity on their bones and muscles. A treadmill, a cycle ergometer, and a resistance exercise machine are the 3 major pieces of equipment they employ. Further, plasma, like other physiological fluids, is affected by zero gravity. Physical activity has been shown to increase plasma levels, leading to the production of more red blood cells, which in turn results in an abundance of oxygen being carried around the body. This is important for astronauts because plasma loss throughout the body causes less oxygen to be carried around, increasing the risk of fainting. Since astronauts are more prone to fainting in zero gravity, regular exercise is crucial to prevent them from being too weak to do their jobs efficiently. Number 5. Astronauts can gain height in space. The vertebrae in our spine are brought closer together by the force of gravity experienced here on Earth. Decompression of the disc occurs as a result of an astronaut being at a location in space that is very near having zero gravity, as a result of which the individual will appear temporarily taller. This condition will continue to exist until the forces of gravity begin to exert their influence after they have returned. However, it might take an astronaut a few months to go back to their usual height after returning from space. Number 6. Astronauts cannot cry. When an astronaut sheds a tear, the watery substance does not go down to their cheeks, but instead pools in a circle around the eyes on their face. The majority of its integrity is preserved as a result of the surface tension of the water. Naturally, their eyes produce tears, but rather than running down their cheeks, they roll into a ball. In other words, strictly speaking, astronauts are unable to shed a tear. You might be able to get a watery material to flow out of your eyes, but it won't fall like water normally does on Earth when it does so. When you cry, rather than having heavy tears roll down your cheeks, you get these odd moist blobs that hang around your eyes. Number 7. Astronauts are trained to use space toilets. Astronauts' bathroom needs change drastically when they're in space. On Earth, when the bladder is 3/4 full, the body sends a signal. In space, however, the bladder does not begin to send signals until it is almost completely full. So, astronauts are trained to use the toilet every 2 hours to prevent genitourinary issues. A unique funnel attached to a hose that leads directly to the toilet is used. The gadget works as well if you're standing or sitting. A spaceship's or station's sewage system will sort out liquid waste from solid garbage. Liquid trash is released into space for the time being, while solid garbage is compressed and stored on board until the rocket returns to Earth. However, NASA is attempting to find a solution to recycle this trash. Number 8. One spacesuit costs $150 million. It was reported that the spacesuit, which was manufactured in 1974, cost between $15 million and $22 million. That is equivalent to around $150 million in today's value. Since that time, NASA has not received any new extravehicular mission-ready suits, and therefore, the space agency is rapidly running out of spacesuits. In point of fact, NASA only has 4 EVA suits that are in a state fit for flight. The reason why spacesuits have such a high price tag is because they are sophisticated, human-shaped spacecraft. Instead of thinking of them as clothing, you should consider them to be spaceships. A spacesuit has to protect an astronaut from the vacuum of space, from radiation coming from the sun and other bodies. It also has to protect against fast-moving particles that are traveling up to 18,000 miles per hour and could penetrate the suit. If a spacesuit fails to do any of these things, an astronaut could be seriously injured. They offer oxygen, communications, telemetry, and everything else that is necessary for a human to exist. And they pack all of this into a small spaceship that is shaped like a human. Number 9. Astronauts' food. The astronauts have a diet consisting of 3,200 calories per day, and they eat 4 times each day. In addition, while deciding what to eat, the preferences in terms of flavor, as well as the national culinary customs of the crew members, are taken into consideration. For instance, sushi was a regular part of the diet of a Japanese astronaut who was stationed on the International Space Station. Pizza was also once brought to the International Space Station as part of a promotional effort for a network of pizza restaurants. However, the majority of an astronaut's meal is composed of foods that come in the form of liquids or paste dispensed through tubes. This is because crumbs from regular foods could get into the ventilation system, break equipment, or get into the respiratory system. That's all for today's video, folks. What fact did you find amazing and were surprised about? Tell us in the comments section. And if you are new to the channel, don't forget to subscribe. Thank you very much for taking the time to watch this video. See you in the next one.